Hello everyone. The MIT's new museum opened its doors to its visitors in a new building in Cambridge in this October. Its exhibition from artificial intelligence to genetic research and biotechnology, all of exhibited research projects, objects and installations tells us not only an innovative and incredible past of a research-based university, but also how it has been creating new chapters in science and advanced technology for a better society and environment. At the entrance gallery of this museum, on the wall, a statement by Dr. Rafael Reif, the MIT president, welcomes the visitors, and I think that it clearly expresses the innovative spirit behind this museum. MIT's greatest invention may be itself, an unusual concentration of unusual talent, forever inventing itself on a mission to make a better world. I visited this inspiring and exciting museum a few weeks ago, and now I would like to invite you to take a tour within its exciting exhibitions. I hope you enjoy this.
Engineered rodents be able to survive on their own in the wild.
We intend to do a field trial on MIT's campus. We're beginning by analyzing the population dynamics to know where individuals and the genetic elements they bring with them are coming from, and how these spread through the population and across campus.
We're also beginning to grapple with some of the logistics and strategies that might make a release successful. One of these is providing responses that will give shelter and resources to engineered individuals in order to give them an edge within the population. We're hoping that this will increase their survival and risk their success, and ultimately mean that fewer engineered animals will have to be released or not.
We have had examples of essential input from these environmental protection equipment, as well as video call centers. These meetings are giving us a deeper understanding of how to cross our existence and see the world that we face in our lives.
Thank you. a laser cutter.
Thank you.
about what it means for a robot to be an effective teammate, what I like to do is look at what makes for an effective human teammate. If we look at pilots and co-pilots, or just, you know, you cooking with your family in a kitchen, there are three aspects to effective human teammates. One is the ability of a person to know what their partner is thinking.
My path to where I am today started with a class I took in high school called Philosophy of Mind. And it was there that I started really engaging with these questions of, you know, what does it mean for a machine to be intelligent? You don't just need a good understanding of the world, you need a good understanding of what you can do in the world. And that's actually a lot harder. I think the statement that we're writing algorithms that we can't read is very, very correct. And in some ways, we can never get to the point where we're going to understand every single process.
start.
Having a background in material science and specifically in the energy sector, I became interested in evaporative cooling because of the simplicity of the technology and the ability for it to have impact on people living in poverty. The beauty of clay pot coolers is that they're simple to make. They can be made with locally available materials in countries like Mali, and you don't have to make them in a super precise way. Evaporative cooling has a lot of potential to improve the shelf life of fruits and vegetables by lowering the temperature and increasing the humidity where they're stored. One really important example of collaboration in this project is how Ph.D and Yetta, a clay potter from the mines of Mali, has contributed a ton of really important ideas and guidance to this project. Originally, we were thinking to focus on training entrepreneurs like her. She said that we also needed to train end users in order to generate demand so that she would have something to sell to. It's one of the really important ways that you want to